Jesus calls us the salt of the earth and the light of the world. That means we are to impact the world, and it means we can impact the world. Because he says, you are the salt of the earth and you are the light of the world. You will make a difference. Oftentimes, we think the gospel ministry is only in words, to give the gospel. But the biblical teaching is that we must also manifest the gospel in works, live the gospel. So you have to give the gospel in your words, but you have to live the gospel in your works. You see, we need to impact people with our works and then also impart to them the words. The works, K, works, cause others to glorify God, as light would do. And our words will then convey the message of salvation they must believe in. And so we must both live the gospel and give the gospel. We can't just live the gospel and not give the gospel. Neither can we be contented with just giving the gospel and not live the gospel. We must both live and give. There must be both works and words. Now that makes life exciting, because the gospel ministry is not just about going overseas to say a few words or to give a few messages. The gospel ministry is everywhere you go, because you can impact your family, friends, neighbors, classmates, colleagues, clients, taxi drivers, store owners, and anyone that God has put you in contact with. Your homes and your offices can be converted into mission fields. You don't have to keep looking for harvest fields. You are already in the harvest as you live the gospel and when the Lord gives you opportunity to give the gospel. So let's live the gospel. Walk with Jesus. Let his life shine through you this week. Let his grace enable you to be gracious to others, to serve others with good works. Do a kind deed to someone. Grace them with your love. Pray for them. Buy them lunch. Build relationships with your friends and neighbors. And let your life impact other lives. And then let us give the gospel. Let them know you are a follower of Jesus. Gently share with them Jesus. Lovingly point them to the cross. You don't have to force the process. Be sensitive to people's feelings. Trust the Holy Spirit to open hearts. But be ready and available to help them draw a step closer to Jesus. Now get help by all means. Your friends in church, care group, discipleship group, your leaders, your pastors will be excited to be part of your team to reach these precious souls. The harvest is already white. You are right in it. So live the gospel and give the gospel this week. God bless.